Hello students, like we have been discussing in the previous module about mixtures being classified as homogeneous mixture and heterogeneous mixture. We already discussed about homogeneous mixture in detail. Now let us start with heterogeneous mixture. Heterogeneous mixture is the mixture in which the constituents are not uniformly mixed throughout the mixture. One more point we are going to note here, the properties and composition of a heterogeneous mixture are not the same throughout the mixture. Now, what does this mean? To understand this, let me take one example. In the example, I am taking muddy water. That means in a jar, I have taken a mixture of mud and water. If I put this muddy water into two different jars, the mixture is divided into two different jars. What do you think is happening here? Can you see the difference? Yes. The composition of muddy water is not the same because in heterogeneous mixture, the constituents are not uniformly mixed. So, muddy water becomes an example of heterogeneous mixture. Now, let us see how heterogeneous mixture is further classified as. It is further classified as suspension and colloid. We are going to learn everything in detail. So, let us first start with suspension. Suspension is a heterogeneous mixture in which the solute particles do not dissolve but they remain suspended in it. And these particles are also visible to the naked eye. Particle size here, students, when I say it's visible to the naked eye, the size is greater than 100 nanometers in diameter. Now, what is NM? NM stands for nanometer. And 1 nanometer is 1 upon 10 raised to 9 meters. Let us see different examples of suspension here. The first one, chalk water suspension. Can you see in the picture? The chalk water suspension. Next one, muddy water, which we have already discussed before. Milk of magnesia is also a suspension. Sand particles suspended in water. Can you see the sand particles being suspended? Yes. And the next one is fluor in water is also an example of suspension. Talking about these examples, students, let us talk about chalk water mixture. Now, this chalk water mixture, if the suspension of chalk and water is kept undisturbed for some time, the chalk particles will start settling down at the bottom of the beaker. Can you see in the picture? In the first picture, we have kept as it is. After some time, the chalk has settled down at the bottom of the beaker. Now, what will happen if I filter the suspension? If I filter, the chalk particles are left behind as a residue on the filter paper. And a clear water is obtained as a filtrate, isn't it? And if the same thing I apply for the muddy water, same thing is going to happen here also. So, if I keep it for some time, the solute particles which were visible to the naked eye have settled at the bottom. The second type of heterogeneous mixture is colloid. Let us define what is colloid. Colloid is a mixture where the size of the particle is less than that of the particle in case of suspension. Here the particle size is between 1 nanometer and 100 nanometers in diameter. These particles are, students, uniformly spread throughout the solution. Due to relatively smaller size of the particles as compared to that of the suspension, this mixture might appear homogeneous to us. But it's not homogeneous, it is a heterogeneous mixture. As you can see in the picture, one is of suspension, other one is of colloid. As a colloidal solution is a heterogeneous mixture, isn't it? The two components of colloid are dispersed phase and dispersion medium. Dispersed phase means, students, the particles which are spread uniformly. And dispersion medium means the medium in which the particles are spread. To understand this, we'll take help of examples. The examples of colloids are soap solution, milk, blood. As you know, blood is invisible to us, right? But what is present in blood? WBC, RBC, platelets. Can you see them with your naked eye? No. But are the constituents present? Yes. That is why it also becomes an example of colloid. Starch solution, ink, and the last one is jelly. These are the examples of colloids. So, with this, we have discussed the definitions of suspension and colloid. Now, let us see the size and movement of particles in suspension and in colloid. First, we are going to start with suspension. Here, I have taken a beaker. Sand in water, it forms a suspension. The particle size is greater than 100 nanometers. And if we keep it undisturbed, what will happen? The particles will settle at the bottom. Sand at the bottom becomes dispersed phase and the top part becomes a dispersion medium. Likewise, let us talk about colloids. In colloids, I am taking the example of ink. Ink in water forms a colloidal solution. Particle size is between 1 nanometer to 100 nanometers. And the particles remain suspended throughout the solution. Can you see there? The dispersed phase and dispersion medium. So with this, we understand the size and movement of particles. Now students, let us see why milk is called as a colloid with the help of a small experiment. I drink one drop of milk. It is examined under the microscope. We can see small particles of fluid floating in the liquid, but under the microscope. Let us see the picture here. Can you see the slide here? You can see small particles. Yes. If there are particles present, that means it's a heterogeneous mixture and colloid. This observation clearly shows us that colloids are heterogeneous in nature, though they appear to be homogeneous to us. Let us study now the most important property of heterogeneous mixture. What can you see here? Two different glasses and one beam of light? Yes. The first mixture is a salt solution and the second one is milk in water. I have taken them in two different glasses. Now let's pass a beam of light through both the glasses. Can you see some difference in both the glasses here? Milk is a colloidal solution where particle size is so small that they scatter the beam of light. I think you can clearly see the difference. In the salt solution, the light is not scattered, whereas in the milk, the light is being scattered. And this scattering of beam of light is called as Tyndall effect. So let us discuss about Tyndall effect in detail. Tyndall effect is caused by scattering of light, which we observed in both the solutions. How is it affecting? How is it scattering? By very small particles in the colloidal solution in a transparent medium. You see a picture here. What is in the picture? Sun rays coming. Can you see the ray of light clearly? Yes. This is also because of Tyndall effect. It is often observed from the dust present in the air when sunlight comes in through the window or comes down through the holes of the cloud. So these all are examples of Tyndall effect. One more example of Tyndall effect is when headlight beams are visible on foggy nights. Can you see here? Yes. This is also an example of Tyndall effect.